Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we are going to learn a topic that is called liquidity risk. Now, what exactly is the liquidity risk? See, this is the very important component for every business. I mean, in every business I'm talking about, liquidity risk is going to be there. So the term liquidity risk means cash crunch situation, and that can come at any time. It's uninvited guest for a temporary or a short time period, and usually it happens during the unseasonal period. This kind of situation are generally having an adverse effect on any business and the profit making organization, because I'll give an example. In 2008, when the mortgage meltdown happened, a very healthy company like General Electric, and they were facing a cash crunch. They make engines, light bulbs. But why? They have faced an amount of risk of liquidity, and due to which they had to call upon the Treasury Secretary that if the business doesn't improve in US, then the business is shutting down. So why this kind of thing? Let's understand what exactly is liquidity risk. The definition, that's the first thing that we are going to learn. Now, the term liquidity risk means the cash crunch situation for a very temporary or a short time period. And this kind of situations are generally having a turmoil effect on any business and profit-making organization. So unable to meet short-term debt or long-term liabilities, the business house ends up with negative working capital, right, in most of the cases. So this is familiar situation which is cyclical in nature and happens during the recession or when a particular economy is not doing well. On the other hand, if the company has an obligation to pay its short-term expenses, payments to its creditors or short-term loans on a monthly basis. Let's take an example of the liquidity risk. I'll give you some of the examples so that you may have an idea. The first example I can give you is the inability to meet the, let's say, the short-term debt due to the exceptional losses, or you can say the damages during the operations. Second, when they are unable to meet the proper funding, okay, with specific time frame. In most of the startup companies, this usually happens. The startup funding based companies, there is a risk of break even. So if the business does not get the next funding, then there can be a possibility of liquidity risk. Now the third and the most important, the rise of the material causes rises in the manufacturing expenses for the concern. So for example, liquidity risk can arise in the commodity prices is not welcome for the business, which in manufacturing like auto ancillaries. So for example, liquidity risk, if we analyze the financial ratios of ABC engineering company, we would find the following. Let's say the revenue grew around 12.17% in financial 18 versus 17. Now this is not for ABC, this is for Suprajit engineering company, and this are the data for the same. The material cost, okay, it had bumped up close enough to 16.06%, and the gross profit had was 45.74% versus 47.56% a year ago. So this was the case with them. Now, because of the rise in the prices of the iron and steel, aluminum, zinc will lower the initial margin of the business due to the higher raw material cost. Now, let's understand what are the measurement, what are the drivers of the liquidity risk. See, one of the prime measurement of the liquidity risk is the application. Remember this thing, application of the current ratio. Now, the current ratio is the value of the short-term liability as per the current liability. So the ideal ratio is believed to be 1, which suggests the firm has the capacity to pay its current liability for its short-term assets. Right. Now, let's move on to the next thing. Now, as you can see the graph on the screen, 4x, 5x, and in the x-axis have the number of years in it. So this is the example of Sears' current ratio. Now, their holding stock fell by 9.8%, okay, on the back of the continuing losses and poorly quarterly results. So Sears' balance sheet doesn't look too good either. And Money Morning has named this company as one of the 5 companies that may go bankrupt. Okay, let's take another example of liquidity risk of Ruchira Peepers Limited, which is an Indian company. Now, the following are the current assets and the current liabilities of Ruchira Papers Limited for the year ending financial year 17 and 18. And we can derive the data as here from the revenue has grew close enough to 6.14% on YOY basis. And the profit before tax has increased by 25.39% or 40% with the PBT margin. The net profit margin has, close enough to in the neighborhood of 7.6% at financial year 17 and 8.36 in financial year 18. And the current ratio was 1.31 versus 1.4 from financial year 17. So this were the couple of examples that I'm giving you so that you can understand what exactly goes wrong in the company. So what are the inferences that you can make out of liquidity risk? See, there are some of the classic liquidity examples. In spite of the higher revenues and higher profitability, the company's current ratio has slipped marginally, whereas the excessive inventory and rising accounts receivable, that is your debtors, put pressure on the working capital, which results in the decrease in the cash and cash equivalents and increase in the short-term borrowings. So the future operation has to be done carefully so as to the account receivables, that is the debtors to sales, should be less than the previous year AR to sales ratio, and there should be an increase in the cash and decrease in the short-term borrowings. Some of the short-term liquidity crises may lead to a long-term, you can say, a negative impact to the business. So as per one of the ace investor, Mr. Warren Buffett, everyone knows him. He says, I have seen more people fall because of the liquor and the leverage. Thus, Mr. Buffett is emphasizing the term leverage as borrowing, or you can say debt, right? So as an example of liquidity risk, the short-term and the long-term borrowing of Bhushan Steel Limited is something as follow. Now, this is the balance sheet data of Bhushan Steel Limited for financial year 14 and 13. The shareholding funds are here, 9161 CR, and in 13. So basically, the shareholding funds have reduced. The short-term borrowings have been increased. The long-term borrowing has been increased. The total borrowings has been significantly been increased. So due to the poor operational efficiency, the business is being funded by the short-term borrowing, which has increased by 20% close enough to yes, 20%, and the long-term borrowing has increased by at least in the neighborhood of 18 to 20%, whereas the shareholding wealth has got slashed by 1%, that is the debt to equity ratio, which should be ideally be less than 1, has increased to 3.45 in financial year 14 versus 2.91 in financial year 13. So how is this liquidity controlled? Now see, there are several instances wherein the unexpected losses of the liquidity crunch could overcome the smart liquidity risk management. The first and the foremost thing is that, you know, a short-term loan or the bank BOD can be taken. The amount should be restricted to the future possible earnings, make this sure, which the company is going to receive in the coming years or days. For example, the liquidity risk management, a sundry debtors will pay the bill in coming 15 days. And hence, the short-term cash crunch can be met by taking a bank BOD of the bill of the exchange. And the second example that we can take, in case of the big order book has been cancelled and no amount has been received against the bill and the manufacturing process has been started, then the liquidity risk management should not hinder the working process. It should not hinder the working process. Rather than that, the liquidity risk management should communicate to the marketing team, okay, so as to sell the excess production at the normal rate and so as to incur the cost of production. Thank you, everyone.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.